on the things which you are doing on the field.
Thank you so much, ma'am. And I'm comfortable with only two languages, English or Hindi. So I want to learn Bangla, but you know, this is really difficult to learn each and every language, because we are coming from Kapi along district of Assam, and when I said Kardom to people, they were happy, because that is their own language, their greeting. So thank you so much, sir, for giving me this opportunity here, and thank you so much, Dada, for helping us in this district, and thank you so much for all of you because you are interested in listening to me. So people used to ignore listening to me, and you are still ready to listen to me. So tell me, should I speak in Hindi or English? Okay. So this is really big challenge for a speaker like me. Okay. So can you imagine why we are here, and from where we are coming, and why we want to meet students of different colleges, and why we want to reach out to people in communities and beyond? Can you imagine? In this country, girls are being sold for the purpose of marriage, post-marriage. Can you imagine that in this country, children are being sold as wives? And if you can imagine, you are practical. But students should be idealist. And each person should be idealist. Even I am idealist. I don't want anyone to be sold for being a wife. This is kind of, you know, abuse of institution of marriage. And this is really worst form of institution of marriage. We actually want to banish them out from this country, and not this country, but this planet. So we are marching against bride trafficking. This is a different form of trafficking, where children and many major women, girls, used to be sold out in different other states, like Haryana, Punjab, Rajasthan, Delhi, or Uttar Pradesh and all. So we were trying to initiate something, and we were thinking to do something for this particular cause, and then we decided to start a march. In 2012, we started a march from Barpeta district of Assam to Kolkata, just to make people aware about bride trafficking, and disseminate the information, like, look, this is happening everywhere in North India, and you have to protect your daughters. But this time we decided to make it more, and we started this march on 25th of March this month, and from Kapi along district to Shimla of Himachal Pradesh. The route actually covers 60% of total trafficking happening in this country. And we will cover 8,000 kilometers. And I really like this. Like, you know, when you say, like, we will travel 8,000 kilometers. So this is kind of, you know, energetic aspiration of a young man. And old people like me have such an aspiration. This is good. And my friends, Elena, Gitesh, Sar- Abhim and Parikshit ji are traveling with us, meeting with the people, police, different other stakeholders, DCPO officers, childline people and others, to understand the depth of the problem. You know, like every time organizations used to work for rescuing someone. Yeah? And in the last district when we visited a survivor, so we were expected to meet a survivor. Survivor ko jante ho, survivor kisko kehte hain?
Okay.
जो किसी चीज को जिसने सरवाइव कर लिया वो सरवाइवर है. सो व्हेन वी वेंट देयर टू मीट द सरवाइवर, सरवाइवर वाज मिसिंग. ओके, शी वाज ट्रैफिक्ड एंड स्पेंड 1.5 years इन समवेयर इन और अराउंड दिल्ली. देन शी वाज रेस्क्यूड एंड शी वाज रिपैट्रिएटेड एट हर होम. And then she was gang raped by local young men, and then she was again trafficked, and no one was aware about that. When we asked the mother why you didn't report this case before the police, mother said that police or people would say like, why this is only happening with your daughter. So this is why that girl, that particular woman was not willing to report that case. So what actually we think as a citizen, being a citizen, what duties we actually have? Being a citizen, we have duty to not only cooperate the administration and statecraft, but also try to make or fix things in a society. You all are law student, no?
Yes.
And you all are going to fight this type of case. Maybe someone will fight for victim or maybe for accused. Huh? So, but being a law student, what is your duty? And being a citizen and an activist, what is my duty? Should I be stop advocating rights of accused? Should we? Should we demand hanging for all accused? Yes? I respect your opinion, but actually I am not angry. We should stand against injustice. We should stand for justice. And what justice is? Justice is that the girl who was trapped somewhere and repatriated here should have a dignified life in the society. If you want to hang someone, you should hang all villagers, because they had a stigma against that girl, which actually enabled the rapist to rape her in a gang. If you want to hang people, hang me and the administration, who actually claim to work against the trafficking and cannot protect a single girl who was repatriated in her home and re-trafficked. So, justice was her dignified life, dignified living condition in the that particular village. And we all are responsible for that, for not giving that. So, being a law student and being a citizen, even if you are not a law student, and even if you are a peasant, farmer or anything, you have some duty for your society. And that duty is taking care of others. So my friends, We are marching against bribe trafficking from Akargalam to Shimla, and we have a single agenda to engage all kind of people with a network so we all can help each other. I would like to invite all of you to join us as a volunteer, make things, fix things, and try to make this country a beautiful place today. Thank you so much. I think.